Install Android 4.2.2 Jelly Bean in the Micromax FUNBOOK Alpha. Here I have a Micromax FUNBOOK Alpha, as you can see here, and let's open it. In the settings and the About Tablet section, you can see here the Android version 4.2.2. Let's open it. Here you can see Android 4.2.2 and Jelly Bean. Let's see some features here. I have got the menu like this, and we have the Google search called Google Now. Here you can search anything through Google Now, but I have another internet settings right now. Alright, so let's begin the installation process. Okay, so you need a USB cable here. Insert the one end of USB cable in the computer and other end to the tablet, but before entering the other end, you have to press the volume down button. Press and hold the volume down button, then insert this cable into the tablet. Then slowly press the power button, like one press per 1 second. Then leave them. You will see a unknown device here in the computer. Just right click in the unknown device and press the update driver software. Then browse my computer. Then search for the live suite you have installed from the download instructions are in the description. So I have here the live suite. Then in the live suite you will see a USB driver folder here. Just open it. Then just click the next button. It will ask you to install the driver. You have to click the install this driver software menu. Okay, installing now. Okay, now after installation, you will see something like a USB device VID 31F3A PID, something like that. You can see here the driver installed. Just close it, and you will see a USB device driver here. And you will see here this is installed. Okay. After the installation, you have to open the live suite. Do not unplug the USB driver now. Just open the live suite. You have to open the live suite as an administrator. Then you will see something like this. Now just unplug the USB from your tablet. Then in the live suite, click yes, then format, then next, then again yes, and find the ROM. The ROM download instructions are in the instructions description. I have the ROM here. Just after selecting, just open it. But do not click the finish right now. Now, here's the tablet time. And just look at here when I install the tablet, insert the USB on the tablet. Otherwise, now the flashing time is here. So press the volume down button and insert the USB inside the tablet. Then press the power button slowly. You will see USB device here. Then press until it disappears. Then just leave it. After it disappear, you will see a live suite dialog box here. You have to press yes. Then you will see another step here. You have to press yes again. Then here you will see the process is going. Okay, so the format has been completed. Just press OK and exit. As you can see here, my tablet booted up. It will take some time, so be patient. It will take time. Just booting up. The first booting will take time. It will take much more time. Okay, as you can see here, the whole process done. The touch screen is not working right now. As you can see here, touch screen does not work. So you have to install the touch screen drivers. I have installed touch screen drivers in the computer. Like here, I have some touch screen drivers. Here, I have to install it. Okay, you have to insert the USB cable to your tablet, and the USB debugging you will automatically connect. Here is an Android device, unknown Android device. You have to install this unknown Android device. So you have to download a file called ADB driver installer, and after downloading, open it. Then you will see Android without device status driver incorrectly. You have to install this. Install this driver software anyway. Just wait. Okay, the driver is now installed, and then after installation just exit, then just open the touchscreen drivers and run it normally. Then it will copy every file and ask you to press any key. Then you have to press a key, then your tablet will automatically reboot like this. It's rebooted. Just wait for the booting ups, and then your touch screen will work. Just let's wait here. You can remove the USB now. Now, as you can see here, the touch screen is now working. You know, here, touch screen is working right now. But if you use the gravity sensor like this, and you use the gravity sensor, you can see here the gravity sensor is not working quite good. But if you want to use the gravity sensor, you have to edit some root files. For that, you have to download the root explorer, and you have to install that. Then you can edit the file. So now I'm gonna download and install the root explorer. Just stay tuned. Okay, guys. So I have installed Root Explorer here. Let's open it. So in the Root Explorer, you have to go to the system file. Then go to the USR file. Then here you will see a gsensor.cfg file. You have to tap and hold it. Then tap on open with. Then tap on text editor. You have to grant a permission to the Root Explorer. Then in the gsensor CFG file, okay, you have to find out the gsensor name MXC622X, like here. Then you have to edit this file. Here in the gsensor directx, you have to edit this file to false. Okay, it's false. Then directy to true. Then directz to false. Then again, XY revert to false.
Okay. After this, you have to go back. But before go back, you will see some warning like this. You have made changes to this file. Do you want to save these changes before exiting? You have to press yes. Then after exiting, you will see a gsensor.cfg.bat file. You have to delete it. No need of this anymore. Okay, so it's deleted. Now, let's reboot the system and let's see what happens to the gsensor. No. Okay, so the tablet is restarted. Let's see how it works, the gsensor. Let's tap like this. What happens? Okay, let's go here. Okay, let's go here. Alright, let's go here. Wow. Okay, now it's working and really good. So, thank you for watching, friends. Just for you see FUNBOOK ALPHA. So, thank you, friends, for watching. Please subscribe and just give some comments. Thank you.